Everybody, it's Victor Hunting Intrigue here in the Binding of Isaac Victor Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you, everybody. The Like Streak Contender moves one more spot down below towards the next goal, which we don't quite have yet. Again, I'm still kind of deciding on that because I want to make sure it's interesting and fun. So be prepared. Be on the lookout for later on this week. Here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you a very fresh meme, not even 8 hours old, posted by your boy Ehoff98. And it goes a little something like this. On the 12th day of Isaac, Eden gave to me 12 tier delay, 11 minute basement, 10 full clears, 9 lives from Guppy, 8 HP upgrade, 7 seals don't take it, 6 angel deals, by God it's pin. 4 tinted rocks, 3 cubes of meat, 2 succubi, and a dead end in the depths, 2. Thank you very much, your boy Ehoff98. Let's hop on in. I'm impressed with the speed that that was. This is... How you doing, Sissy? Yeah, we've got good damage, bad, somewhat bad tiers, terrible shot speed. We've got good damage. Excuse me. We also have the Unicorn Stump and Large Zip, but we also got Sissy! Whoever said that Eden's Blessing couldn't give us a good item, not me, coach. Little Sissy, given to us from Eden's Blessing on yesterday's run. There's our tiers upgrade for us. Thank you, Sissy. The Unicorn Stump is going to give us invincibility. I probably shouldn't be doing this, but I'm going to anyway. Just really hoping that there was going to be a be some kind of combat in there, so we, or a full charge, so we could have gotten a fresh charge, full charge, fresh full charge on our Unicorn Stump. But of course, if we get a, if we end up getting any kind of orbital at all, I mean any kind, we are set for pretty much the entire run. Sad Onion, of course, just destroyed the problem that we had, which was, of course, our tier delay, which went from 12 to 8. It's a very nice upgrade there. And we had little Sissy. How you doing, Sissy? It's great to see you. We were worried about you. Today is truly a blessed day for the 12 days of Isaac 2020. I seriously contemplated going through the entire thing, but I was like, I feel like people would get annoyed. So I know that some people would probably really like it if I started from like day one, but yeah, I figured I better not. Let's respect people's time and all that stuff. So let's see now. Let's really see who's gonna do a heavy metal cover of that. That's what I'm waiting for. So if you have a band and you want to get my attention, then do a heavy metal rendition of the 12 Days of Isaac. Okay, so we have no soul hearts to speak of to cover our HP. There's an invisible leaper in front of us. So sorry. Help us, Sissy. All these leaping champions, careful. Are a little bit of a pain. Yep, saw that one coming. I'm glad that I hit it. I'm going to wait in the corner here. Sissy. Sissy, work your magic, Sissy. Here we go, Sissy. Unicorn Stump saving us from losing our devil deal there. Oh, look at that. Sissy taking out one of the monstros after they split from the green champion. You got to be careful of the leapers, though, because they like to break the physics and just not listen to the game. That was a champion. All these mobs in here were champions, which kind of sucks. But yeah, you saw right there, Sissy Longlegs is going to give us an attack spider, which deals 250% of our damage, and our base damage is still very high. We also have the Eve lipstick as well, or at least the black lipstick. I call it Eve's lipstick because Eve wears black lipstick. But obviously we need a Yave for us to get into our item room, which we may have to go to the La Tienda for, but we can't get into the La Tienda without no Yave. So, you know, we're back to square one pretty much here, Sissy. Got a Sun card. Sun card's going to give us a full heal and show us the map and compass effect, which I'm going to use in this room because screw everything in that room. And the shop is way, way, way over there. So yeah, so we end up getting Mom's Pearls from the first floor boss, which is about as unexciting as it sounds. Hopefully we get an orbital here. I mean, we're one sack dagger away, Sissy. And we're just going to try to beast mode this and not get hit so we don't lose the devil deal, which is easier said than done, of course, with four Larrys. So we want to take down the smaller Larrys first just because they're just easier to kill. And then we can focus on one. So we'll go for that one here. Doing great, Sissy. Keep it up, Sissy. There we go. Attack spider there from Sissy. Sissy Longlegs doing us proud. We're going to get ourselves Roid Rage, no orbital, and a first floor Krampus fight because lol, 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 lol. So that's fun. And that's about as trolly as the game can get on floor two with a Krampus devil deal. At least we got Lump of Coal, I suppose. All that money, by the way, came from our golden heart that we had above our, or that we had on our first heart. So we didn't lose the heart, we just lost the gold heart. And once that happens, it shatters into a bunch of money. Basically, I'm just breaking those for money. We can get into the secret room, so it's good. Is muy bueno. But what isn't muy bueno is our lack of llaves. Should be able to hit both of the pots right there. There we go. We get Swallow Penny, which is pretty darn good. And there's a Yave. Problem is, we can't get to it. So we're going to drop one of these here La Bombas, get ourselves a Tinted Rock. But the problem is that we don't need that Soul Heart right now. We're over here, and we just got to hope that we get a key. I mean, on a run like this, like, it's not a death sentence, of course, if we miss one item room in one store, but it's not good. Like, it's far from good. Get into God's Rune, which would give us the Soul Heart and purge the curse on, not this floor, but the next floor. There's no curse on this floor. And I'm just about done with curses today. We played in an impromptu NLSS, which this, I think the NLSS video will be up on YouTube for you all to see. Myself, Robert, Bear, and Josh, we all played Phasmophobia. Pretty sure it's Phasmophobia. It's a multiplayer early access horror game where you play as ghost hunters, and your job is to, based on evidence, is to suss out the type of ghost that you're dealing with. And it's as fun as it sounds. It is pretty good. I don't like playing horror games, not because I'm a big scaredy cat, but just because I usually get bored with them. However, this one was actually genuinely kind of scary because of the fact that, like, my friends were involved. And there's one, I don't want to spoil it, but there's one particular moment where like, I get really, really scared for one of, I'm not going to say who, but for one of our teammates. Volatar is not what we're looking for. Parasitoid, however, is. Parasitoid's huge. That's a big-time get for us. So we finally get a key, but unfortunately, we can't get into the store, and it did cost us all of our money. So I will probably put that video out for... Oops. I'll probably put that video out for Wednesday's extra content in the 2 o'clock spot. So Wednesday will be Isaac and then Phasmophobia. It's not Phantasmophobia. That's an entirely different game. As I found out the hard way on Steam when I almost bought it. So, but it's pretty neat. It's impressive that it's made by only one developer, and there are a lot of bugs in it. I mean, it is early access, but what I will say is that the foundation that the developer has made, it's a single person developer as well. I didn't say it already. But the foundation that the developer has established is pretty impressive already. And man, if it gets like a big budget behind it, that would be something spectacular. So it's pretty neat. Those of you who are in the mood for a spooky game here, I don't play horror games that often. I think we do have one Haunted Forest VOD somewhere on the channel. If someone wants to go link that, sure. But other than that, I mean, like, you know, people have always asked me to play FNAF. People have asked me to play Amnesia because that's just like the go-to on here on YouTube. And I've watched other people play it. I'm just like, eh. I like jump scares. They're just annoying. You know, that's the thing. That's the thing for me is that they're genuinely annoying. I you would have the same for me. if you wanted to make your own, like, FNAF game, for example, which, I mean, the FNAF franchise, it is infinitely intriguing to me. And, you know, watching YouTube videos on it, you know, what Scott Cawthon has done with that, with just making something out of nothing into a multi, you know, million-dollar franchise is really, really spectacular. But, I mean, no offense to his games. However, if I wanted to make my own FNAF game, I would just simply put a bunch of random loud sounds in like an Excel spreadsheet and then blindfold the person and say, okay, just hold down and then hit enter when you're done holding down. And if you get a sound, great. If you don't, hey, look, you lived. Now you're playing FNAF, you know. I realize it's an unfair comparison because it's a little bit more involved in gameplay-wise, but you get the idea. It's just, I'm not a huge jump scare fan. But what I will say is that Phasmophobia definitely has a level of suspense that I've not really experienced before in other games like it, because you have to look out for your actual like friends, and on top of that, you know, the mystery of I don't know what we're dealing with right now. You know, it could speak to us, it could threaten us, it could be nonviolent. I mean, you know, there's plenty of different types of ghosts in the game so far, and with hopes that the developer's gonna be adding more. So I'm hoping that the game gets popular and takes off, so it receives the the proper funding and stuff, as it is in early access. That would be really, really cool. And the ghosts, your question was probably the same as my question, was like, well, you know, it can't be that fun if one person's playing the ghost. Like, that's kind of lame. Like, it's basically just Dead by Daylight at that point. But no, the AI controls the ghost. And you have to talk to it and stuff. And sometimes it will respond if it can. Sometimes it won't. You know, it really is impressive what's there right now. Our second Yabe, and okay. It's really unfortunate that Temperance Machine broke when it did, because we had plenty of opportunity to get a good amount of money here. You know what? We're fast enough. I can go pick up that full charge. The only reason why I don't mind doing that is because there's a full charge in here, so that ain't no thing. We can still use it for the boss if we need it, sissy. Here we go, little sissy. There's no way I'm passing up tarot cloth here. Absolutely none. Get a tower card. Okay, I think that's good for now. I'm going to hold off on buying anything else. Super Secret Room might be to the right of there, but I think I'm just going to hold on to this bomb for the next floor. And let's go see who we've got going on here in this El Jefe room. I don't know. I'm not sure how you would say boss room. And we get Pestilence, which is actually huge time, huge for us, because that means that we are going to have an orbital with this combo, which is, I mean, that's phenomenal. Parasitoid, by the way, is a tier effect that allows us to shoot out the eggs, which will either spawn attack spiders or attack flies. And yeah, that's a big old GG right there, Johnson. Still no use for the Degas rune yet, but you might be saying, well, how come it's a GG? Well, because remember, the Unicorn Stump is on a one-room cooldown, which essentially means that we can walk into any room as long as we have a full charge. We can walk into any room, in every room, and lead off with just orbital damage with absolute impunity. Like, we've got nothing to worry about at all right now. And you see how fast it resets here. So, you know, having the unbeatable combo is pretty nice. Now, some people may not like it because, obviously, like, we're just destroying things with an orbital, but it's a good combo to get used to, and it also gives you good practice for using orbitals. So if you end up playing the seed, which I realized I didn't read out because I was too busy geeking out about little sissy. If you play the seed, though, then use it to practice orbital play. By the way, 68%. La 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 la. Rit X291. There you go. All right, let's go back and now that we have nothing to fear about our devil deal, because we don't get devil deals here. Got nothing to fear. Tell him, sissy. Go get him, sissy. Guppy's head. Guppy's head, while it is good, it is not what we're looking for, sadly. I mean, not sadly. It's a good problem to have, like two good spacebar items, except one in this case is way better than the other because of another item. And that other item would be the unicorn stump. So see here, we're not dealing contact damage with Isaac's body, but we're dealing contact damage with the orbital itself. Kind of weird how the key didn't move right there, even though it was on top of an explosive barrel. And thanks to Roid Rage and Blood Bag, we're kind of just zipping around. Not a care in the world here. Just go Monty. I'm going to take Monstro's Lung mainly because we have Lump of Coal. Monstro's Lung does destroy our tears rate, but I think it's worth it. Especially considering that we've got Parasitoid, that just gives us more... It gives us more firepower, and it gives us more tears to proc with. I'm going to use a key here because we have more keys than bombs. We get Red Candidu, which I'm not going to be taking. And BFF. Or we can get Big Sissy. Oh, she didn't change at all. Okay. Pandora's box. It is an item, I believe, a boss item. I think. Let's use this. Yeah, you know, let's use it in here. It's a range upgrade and two soul hearts, I'll take it. And I think that will be that. Ah, thought I could get away with it. Yeah, let's, I mean, we can use this for that. There we go. All right, no problem at all. Okay, it's fine. I didn't want to lose that soul heart, but it's fine. The super secret room could have been left to the left of the room that's left of the shop. That makes sense. But I don't want to use any bombs to look for it just because it's, I mean, let's be honest, the super secret rooms rarely ever are worth it, especially in this day and age. Curse the Blind, yeet! Alright, so we don't have to worry about Curse the Blind anymore, as that would have been kind of annoying on this floor especially. Have our full charge back. I'm going to take the risk here. I would say it was worth it. I mean, we got both of our keys back and then some. So, ain't no problem there. And as you see right here, this is the reason why you want Unicorn Stump with an orbital. Because we didn't have to do anything in this room, and we absolutely handled things. Strength card is good for two Red Heart containers if we need them. For some reason, if we get the ultra rare... Devil Deal. I thought I hit that in time. Apparently not. We get the ultra rare Devil Deal that's like three two heart deals. It does happen from time to time, but it's very, very rare. We have the shotgun effect of Monstro's Lung, which is the reason why you want to take it. And another reason why I want to take it with Lump of Coal is because it does have you can throw Monstro's Lung shots like a considerable distance from Isaac, and it deals a good amount of damage with Lump of Coal. I can bomb my way over. So if you didn't know, if you ever find a room like this and you're like, oh man, I can't get to that golden chest. Imagine it's a golden chest or an item or something. You can actually bomb poop piles and it will create a rock pile that will bridge the gap for you. Little known trick there that not a whole lot of people are aware of. This is the only downside of Monstro's Lung, is that it does kill your tears rate. So being able, oops, sorry, Sissy. being able to, being like, you have to kill the enemy that you shoot at before it, I mean, if they just bounce it off, like, you're going to be in a little bit of trouble there. Kind of a bad angle here on Unicorn Stump. Still got most of them. All right. And we get Hive Mind Parasitoid Sissy. Oh, my goodness. That is big. Now she's big sissy. Oh, it's mega sissy. Look at her. Now she's even 100% cuter. Good job, Sissy. And Sissy's almost the size of Isaac. And Hive Mind is just going to make her spiders do even more damage here. Let's go fight the boss real quick. Gonna be Gish. That's a big rip on that. An angel deal. It's Eden Soul and Breath of Life. Fantastic. So without any way of actually getting a full charge of Eden Soul, I mean, if we had some way like Sharp Plug or something, I would have taken Eden Soul, used it in there, and hoped that we got a good item. But I'm not giving up. I'm not giving up this combo. And that's full clear, by the way. Just looking for the item room. All right, still rocking and rolling, Isaac. Can't get away from the full clears. Wow, and the mulligan. What in the world is going on here? We've got so many good items that synergize with each other. It's a little bit scary. Parasitoid, Hive Mind, Sissy, and now the mulligan, which is going to give us attack flies every time we make contact with a hostile target. And that's pretty... I mean, even though we haven't gotten any damage upgrades yet, that is a lot of damage we're bringing to the table. Okay. Demon Judgment is a go. We're going to be playing first. Remember, we have Swallow Penny. That's the reason why we're getting pennies here. Every time we take damage, cough up a penny. Master lockpicking, which is great because this is the last time that Swallow Penny will probably be useful to us. I'm going to hit the Unicorn Stump real quick. Empress card. Yeah. I think we'll take the Strength card. Oh, you jerk. Okay, so before we start using all of our full charges on Unicorn Stump to get something out of the arcade, or to get more money, I should say, we need to make sure that our store is good first. The Master Lockpicking is going to give us free golden chests for the rest of the run, as long as we're holding on to it, or if we trinket smelt it, that would be nice as well. Lots of temperance machines here. Now, unfortunately, we didn't get any teleportation card, which means that we're not going to be able to skimp out of Boss Rush as much as I would love to. Yeah, and that's kind of the reason why I didn't want to play. I didn't want to use all of our time and energy to try to use, like, to try to go through the arcade and stuff. It's just because it's not going to be worth it. If there was a greed fight in there, or if it's just a crappy store like it was, then, you know, that's we saved ourselves a lot of time and possible headache there. Super Singing Room might be here. Okay, I'm going to Black Soul Heart. Good. Here we go, Sissy. We got Mega Sissy. And the hunt for our item room continues. Just imagine if we get more damage. Like, our Hive Mind spiders and Sissy spiders and our Mulligan flies are just going to go outrageous in terms of damage. Yep. And remember, we do have BFF, which means that our Cuban meat is also dealing more damage as well. So, you know, it's an elite level amount of damage that we're doing here. And then you couple the fact that we got Sissy and Hive Mind and freaking Parasitoid and Mulligan as well. Yeah, that's insane. And the Keeper. You should know that I don't like that item. And there's no good reason not to like Head of the Keeper. I just don't like it because it makes me feel like I do less damage. I'm not the only one in thinking that. Some people are like, oh my god, come on. But some other people are like, yeah, it does make you kind of feel like you're dealing less damage. It's kind of weird. If I was the only person who was saying that, then yeah, sure, call me crazy. But I do not want Lacrimogy. Not with Monster's Lung. It might work okay with Lump of Coal, considering just the mechanics of Lump of Coal, but for the most part, I'm going to go ahead and pass. Yeah, good damage there on Mom. There we go. No deal with the devil. No surprise there. We'll just keep on going, baby. Again, Sissy's damage is not negligible, especially when you throw, if you factor in Hive Mind in there. Those extra attack spiders, 250% of our attack every single time Sissy does something. That's real good. That's just extra damage she's giving. So, you know, as much of a kind of a mascot as she's become for the Mosh Pit, at least in Isaac anyway, she does have some functional advantages. I mean, there's no reason not to be happy when you see Sissy. Not only does she love you, but she also gives you the damage, hooks you up with attack spiders. I mean, what more could you want? They're going for this way because of that bomb rock. I'll just take care of business real quick here. Happy to say that I'll be moving all my office stuff, my rig and everything. I'll be moving in permanently probably tomorrow on Wednesday. So Wednesday night for the Wednesday stream or Wednesday day night stream, I will be streaming for the first time and recording for the first time ever in the new house. Today they need to go back tomorrow and they're finishing up some stuff in the office. But they got the major stuff out of the way with the alarm system and everything. Now it's hooked up. We got cameras all over the place. It's pretty heavy duty. And, I'm impressed with the workmanship and craftsmanship of the company that I hired. But what's really cool is that I've got one of those cameras at the door, like at the front door. So I can actually see my phone will tell me when there's like someone there, and I can actually speak to them. There's an intercom that's built on top of it. So like I could be anywhere in the world, as long as I have access to a Wi-Fi network, and be able to see who's at my front door and talk to them. It's pretty amazing. And I started thinking about like what would we have said about this technology, like 15 years ago. Even 10 years ago, people would have been like, that's absurd. We can't, like, you know, broadband cannot possibly get that fast and all this stuff. It's like, well, but what if it did? Pretty horrible unicorn stump usage, I gotta say. Yeah, we got belly button, which gives us a second trinket slot. Hooray. We get Dark Bum and Mega. I'm going to take Dark Bum. I'm not going to take Mega because I don't think that we need it. I mean, Mega speeds things up, but like, no, I'm going to stick with this combo. Yeah, if I could, like, if I could talk to myself 10 years ago, 15 years, let's say 15 years ago, and say, dude, there's this technology now where you can be anywhere in the world as long as you have a cell phone, and you can see, get a live, like, lagless, like, video feed of your home, and you can also speak to the people through an intercom that's built on the door without having to be there. I'd be like, dude, there's no way. Like, that technology, that's like, that's some Star Trek levels of technology. And then here we are. And it's pretty nuts. I would have also said, stop eating all those god dang candy bars. I actually like candy bars. Sharp Plug's not bad, especially half price, but I think we can do better. Help a sissy. Come on, sissy. Here we go, sissy. All right. Like, what, and this would be your topic of the day. What technology, if you could tell yourself or tell somebody, you go back 20 years, just keep it simple, say 20 years instead of 15. 20 years ago, the year 2000, assuming that you were alive back then, what piece of technology would you tell yourself about that you think would have made your former self just freak out? And no, none of the internet's not made of tubes jokes or anything like that. It's just, come on now. We can do better. We can do better, Mosh Pit. Just wanted to get her weak enough, and we didn't get a double deal, and that's no surprise there. Some mapping would have been nice. But on a run like this, you don't really need it anyway. I mean, like I said at the very beginning, if we get an orbital, that's GG. And it absolutely is. Being able to stop yourself from taking any and all forms of damage is extremely useful and powerful in this game. There we go. Saw the shotgun effect there of Monster's Lung burst down the horse from death. Yep. I don't know, man. Let's go over. Let's try this way. Got a Hoggle's rune. I mean, truth be told, we don't need that AWOS rune either. I was just hoping that we're going to get the guys rune at some point. Yeah, I think that remote technology would be up there in terms of, like, freak outage. I think the 3D printing would definitely be up there. Apologies for those of you if that was your answer. I'm going to try to stay focused and say, you know, what kind of technological advancement would make yourself, your nerdy self, freak out about. Say that to myself. And we kind of lead off there with Monstro's Lung. Chest. Oh man. So yeah, let me know what you think about Phasmophobia. I don't anticipate it being a series or anything. Oh my gosh. Well, our tears rate's about to get shot straight to HE double hockey sticks, but our damage just got hooked up fat. and quite literally, in fact, yeah, you're seeing the damage there of BFF plus our now 9.34 base damage, which was already doing some pretty good amounts of damage before we got Polyphemus and freaking Inner Eye. Inner Eye is going to make us fire three more shots, which, of course, makes our Cures rate a lot slower. And Polyphemus, which has the pseudo-piercing, is what I like to call. Polyphemus is also one of those super rare items that you really don't... You only hear about, but you never see. Dude. And let's see if it's this way. Okay, nope. All right, there's one wing down, Isaac. Check out south here. Okay, it's going to be dead end. Good. Got Gertie Jr. off guard there. She didn't know that I had a full charge on the unicorn stump. And now we're finally ready to go in the right direction. He hopes. Ran into the creep there. Boost speed's a little too high. Dude, Isaac. There we go. Seeing here the amount of windup for our tears to go off is quite punishing. Dark Bomb, of course, going to help us with that HP. Little Sissy still just helping us just by being there and being cute. Mega, which is good. I will go down here. And not the right play, because this is not the right way. I think 3D printing would definitely have to be up there. And just the power of like cell phones, really. Like, we didn't have smartphones back then. In 2000, you were lucky if you had any Apple product that wasn't an iPod. Golden Bomb here, which is fine. We're just doing a... Okay, yep. And there you go. There's the full clear. All right. We had to do it. You love to see it. So full clear in full effect, Sissy. It's all right. She's happy. Sissy's happy because it's just more time that she gets to spend with us. I think that's the real reasoning behind this god-awful map. How does he do it, et cetera, et cetera. Some people were asking if I was going to put Genshin on the main channel. The answer is no. If I had the mobiles game channel set up, which I still don't right now, but if I did, I would put it on that channel. Anything mobile related will go on the Sinvicta mobile channel whenever I come up with it. You know what, little Monstro, come on in. Come on, ride the Monstro train. I mean, we've already got one Monstro item, might as well have another one. Yeah, now unfortunately we don't have car battery, so we're not gonna get the double duration from Unicorn Stump. Not that we need it, of course, because we are just smoking everything right now. I had a family member ask me if I was going to get a smoker. I said, like, for, like, meat and stuff. And I was like, no. No, I think I'm good. Smoke it, like, here's the thing about smoked meat. I don't like it. I don't particularly enjoy the taste of smoked meat. I'd rather it be cooked, not smoked. Some people are like, oh, you can't say that. Smoking is a form of cooking, you nerd. I'm like, yeah, I mean, I guess so, but it's not my favorite. I have to be in the mood for something smoky. So either way, we're going to get the win here. Thank you all very much for making it possible. Again, we are roaring ahead for the next like streak goal, which I will have for you by Wednesday. Let's put it that way. And really, MVP here goes to Monstro's Lung. And I guess Dark Bone. But I mean, let's be honest. We all know who the major player is. She's the queen and a half. She's actually like more like two queens today. Little Sissy making her return. Thank you for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this video, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Either way, it supports my channel. Subscribe and ring the notification bell so you get notified when my newest videos go live here on YouTube. Thank you all very much for the continued support. I really appreciate it. Hope you had a great start to your week. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine, like First Name, Last Name, Killer Krig, Michael McMaster, Oliver Went, and Josh Watson. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then please go to my Patreon page, which you can find at patreon.com/Sinvicta.